Hello everyone. Now, this video is quite long and it's one which I hope finds you all safe and well. It's a video I've put together during this very pleasant first day of the holidays, because I'm aware that so many of you prefer the video updates rather than reading the long letters. Please definitely watch the first bit, it's all about thank yous, and the last bit, it's all about support. The other bits are all signposted for you along the way. I know I did my final letter of the school year yesterday, that it was the 51st letter that I've issued since the start of COVID during February of last year. I'm aware that some are very long and my apologies for that. I've had to give you lots of very important information and we are a very large and vibrant school. Of course, they do come in sections just like this video. Together, we are senior pupils and staff. We've also provided over 100 YouTube videos. In fact, I think it's over 130. And these keep me up to date with what's going on in the school. My thanks to everyone who's given up their evenings and their weekends and their holidays to produce these wee videos. Our communication and thereafter the support for all our pupils and parents alike is primarily centred on the pastoral teams for each clan. We've got clan guidance teachers, we've got clan deputes, family liaison officers for each clan, youth worker, learning support assistants and IT support staff. I'm pleased that we've been able to offer all our family support that's included learning, IT, devices and connectivity, free food, clothing, and most importantly of all, a compassionate understanding and a helping hand during the very difficult times that we're all facing currently. My thanks to these wonderfully dedicated, committed and compassionate individuals. Our school's a large organisation with many staff who are available to support the care and the learning of our community. Our large business requires the support of our office and our finance staff, our technicians, our janitors, cleaners and catering staff. These staff have maybe less contact with our children than the teachers and the assistants, but without their professionalism and hard work, we wouldn't have the infrastructure to provide the care and the learning that we do provide. And I think it's important to remind everybody in Oban High School that it rarely closes. We're not all on holiday 12 weeks a year, as some folk keep making out. Our school's a community school. It's open 50 of the 52 weeks of the year. It's open days, nights, weekends and holidays. And these staff just mentioned in particular support me throughout the whole year to offer a wealth of wider opportunities for our children and to ensure that we're prepared for coming back in the new sessions. The support of our children and our families is not restricted to those whom we employ directly either. We've got many partner organisations who, even during the COVID times, have continued to support our school and provide opportunities for our youngsters. The most notable of these are the Education Support Team, the Central Education Team and the Digital Learning Team, all of whom continue to provide support to our children. A recent example to be highlighted, because the closing date is nearly on us, it would be the establishment of the Summer Activities Programme. And for a list of summer holiday opportunities that are further expanded by that, you can look on Live Argyle, another of our partners, who are a very valuable and important organisation for us. FES, or Oban Electrics, maintains our new school to an exceptionally high standard. Education Transport, West Coast Motors, ScotRail, CalMac and Hebridean Air, they all bring kids to school from far and wide. Our school hostel cares for those from the islands. Our primary partners provide the foundations for all we teach in the high school. And this education is further broadened through the many courses offered to us by Argyle College, the Open University, and most recently, the Engineering Foundation Apprenticeships that are supported by Comra na Elinsar. Now, I could add to this video by adding over 90 different partners, some local, some national, and a few international, but I feel my viewers may not bear with me. So, to all those that I've not listed, please rest assured that we will continue to value and appreciate your support, and I will definitely sing your praises throughout the year. Now, these are my thanks. Thanks shared by all those who benefit from these partnerships. My one final thanks, though, would be to those who have written emails and cards, called in ever-increasing numbers showing their support for our school. The thanks, the praise and the support shown by so many parents and by the Parent Council in particular is heartening. The recognition of the leadership, and the efforts of all our staff in navigating successfully these turbulent times with constant changes linked to COVID restrictions. Our health and safety measures, our timetables, our courses, our assessments, and the way in which we teach both online and live is very much appreciated. This week, I also had the privilege to discuss our COVID arrangements and our qualifications and our wider successes and even some concerns that we have with the HMI, most of the local councillors, the community council, and the education team members, which included the Director of Education. Now, everyone involved have offered their support to our school, and they've asked me to pass on their thanks to our dedicated staff and pass on their congratulations to all our pupils. Job done. Such support and such praise goes a long way in reaffirming that our community value the work we do and the success that we achieve. On the letter that I added, there are a couple of links I can't put in the video. One is to do with the school improvement plan. It's been consulted over the last 6 or so weeks, and that will form all the basis of all the changes and all the adaptations and all the continuation of everything that we've been doing for the last year or two. It will cover health and wellbeing, including post-COVID-19 recovery. It covers developing the young workforce and our skills framework. It will cover high quality feedback as part of our teaching and learning, developing and measuring engagement for learning. Differentiation is a key factor in improving learning, and we're going to focus on that too. Equity, division and inclusion, pupil voice, and a whole school aspect on literacy, as well as the one that we've already had for numeracy. There's a number of other initiatives detailed in the planning document. It's huge. Please read the summary at the very least. Now, the standards and quality report is another important document that we've attached. It's on the website and also the links on the letter. It shows the considerable progress and success in spite of all the restrictions that everybody's been living under. And if you check up the website or use the link in the letter, you'll be able to read all about the school's successes, including the SQA results. And can I thank everyone who played such an important part in generating these results for this year. The deadline was the 25th of June. It was quite difficult to meet that deadline given timescales, but we managed it admirably. If you have received, or you haven't received, I should say, your provisional grades, then please look in your Glow email inbox. Check out the junk just in case as well. And if there's any difficulties, as always, please just use the Contact Us page on the website. And as I said, we're not completely shut. Someone will get back to you. Now, we recognise that not everyone will have been satisfied with all the results. Many of you have been in touch to discuss your results, your future career pathways, etc. with staff. You should keep doing that. But if you're not happy with the results in particular, please use the appeal service. That's why it's there. All the details of the appeal service can be found on the SQA website. Your results are being finalised by the SQA, and your final awards, including the Skills for Work, college courses, foundation apprenticeships, etc., they'll be communicated to you by the SQA themselves on Tuesday the 10th of August. You can sign up, as always, to receive the results by text by registering through the My SQA website. Induction days. Induction days for our new S1s will take place on Monday the 16th of August and Tuesday the 17th of August. New S1 pupils should meet staff and senior pupils in the avenue, that's at the front of the school, at 10 to 9 on that Monday in full uniform. We'll have ties available, so don't worry about the ties. Clan leaders and the S6s will be on hand to help the youngsters. They'll all be behind clan banners, so as long as you know what clan you're in, you'll be fine. And even if you can't remember what clan you're in, all you have to do is find one of the deputy heads or one of the guidance teachers who will be easily noticeable, and they'll make sure to point you in the right direction. Now, day one of the induction process will see S1 pupils spend time in their clan class with their clan teacher, their guidance teacher and their family liaison officer, so they get to know others in the class and these key staff. On day two, similar to a normal induction day, we'll have them coming into school in their PE kit, no full uniform required that day. They'll be in PE all day participating in team building activities so that everyone gets to know different people in their year group and not just their clan classes. S1s will have an adapted timetable, their break times, their lunch times, etc., so that we can spend more time with them let them get to know the building in peace, and they'll find that quite beneficial. So we look forward to welcoming all the S1s to Oban High School in August. Now that's the S1s. Of course, everyone else, all our children should return to school on the 16th of August, and I'm sure they'll all settle in well. To begin with, we'll follow all the same health and safety and timetable arrangements as we do today. That will ensure clarity in the expectations, and it will ensure that we return smoothly. If there's any new guidance issued during the holidays, then I'll make sure that the changes, once we've had time to look at them, are implemented early into the new term. Now, another important thing. Following discussion with last year's senior pupil leadership team, we now have changed the date of prize giving. We've changed it to Thursday the 2nd of September. My thanks to Joy Dunlop for agreeing to be our guest of honour. This change of date is going to allow our pupils more time to prepare for any dinner or any dance, COVID restrictions allowing, that we managed to put on Friday the 3rd of September. My special thanks to the very popular and regular Jingles band, The Chunks, for agreeing to play that evening, Friday the 3rd. They'll either play indoor, or they'll play outdoor, or maybe they'll not play at all, depending on COVID, but fingers crossed for that. Another thing that we've got planned, just to give you some advance notice, is our Live and Learn session. In order to support the pupils with their learning and their assessments in the coming academic year, we've booked revision skills and growth mindset workshops for all pupils in S4, S5, S6. The first of these sessions will take place in October, and there will be follow-up sessions in February. There will also be parental engagement sessions where you'll be given information on how best to support your child with their learning and to help them achieve their full potential. And more details will follow. As always, should you require any support at all, whatever it may be, or should you have any questions, any ideas, or even any concerns, please either use the Contact Us page on the website or contact your child's guidance teacher. I hope you all have a lovely summer holiday. I'm away off to walk the dogs now. Enjoy.